Liu a Liu, how can I ensure the dividend income from the stocks I'm holding or buying is always consistent?
That question is flawed, but just to make sure we're on the same page, explain more. What is it really you want to accomplish?
Say if I have a 1 million retirement fund invested into a stocks portfolio which gives me, say, a 6% dividend yield, that's 60,000 per year or 5,000 a month regardless of the fluctuation of my retirement capital. How can I ensure it will forever give me 60,000 dividend consistently forever? So I don't need to touch or sell a single stock from my 1 million capital. You get it?
Oh, so you are talking about keeping your dividend generating retirement capital intact. So you never had to worry about running out of money, right? Nope, trust me, you don't want that.
Ah, yes, yes. Wait, what?
I say you don't want to hold a basket of stocks or any investment portfolio that forever generates you a consistently flat 6% dividend.
Huh? Why not?
Because of inflation. Sure, you are comfortable with your passive dividend income of 60,000 per year now, but practically you need that dividend income to also grow faster than the inflation rate. Now say this year your dividend income is 60,000. Yes, you are happy, but in the second year the dividend income say grow 5%, so you are now getting 63,000 for that year. And then in the third year that dividend say also grows 5% on top of what you are getting in the second year, so 63,000 becomes 66,000 in the third year. Now that is the effect of compounding. Are you getting this?
Wow, Liu, why you so sharp one? I thought I know what I need. Turns out I don't really know leh. But in 5 minutes, you are able to hit all the points where it truly matters. Nobody really talk about this on YouTube eh.
Can you see the difference now between a real practitioner versus fake gurus and half past 6 finance YouTubers, bloggers out there? Also because the entire financial industry is too focused on products and the end goals. And worse, they are oversimplifying things that only work today, but it is not sustainable in the long run. And I call that touch and go approach. What I feel is really lacking and what's really important is the process-oriented approach to construct and manage a dividend stocks portfolio that not only gives you the passive dividend cash flow that you need today, but also comes with a growth rate that outpaces inflation rate in wherever country or region that you live. Agree? If yes, how about tapping once on that like button below? Thank you very much for your supportive response. Now that is the main focus, if you ask me, when I'm doing a one-on-one coaching and advisory for my clients.
Oh, now I understand. Instead of looking for consistent dividend income, what's more important is a consistently growing dividend income, huh?
Abuden, like, you want to prevent constipation. Is it enough for you to drink enough water and only eat enough fiber for one day? Or you need to consistently drink enough water and eat enough fiber?
On point, on point. But what is the strategy to pick stocks with consistently growing dividends leh?
I ask you, what type of business distribute dividend? The one making profit or the one losing money?
Easy, the one that is making the profit.
So increasing dividend is usually only possible with increasing profits. Do you agree?
Yep, agree.
That is your answer. If you are buying stocks now, find company with increasing profits. Now, if you are already holding a dividend stocks portfolio, ensure that the listed company in your portfolio still generates increasing profits.
Okay, this part I find it hard. Do I look at the historical financial data, annual reports and all that, or how?
Annual report and historical financial data represent the past. Do you really think stock prices move based on historical data? Or do you think stock prices move based on future prospects?
I guess future prospect of the stocks. But what makes a good future prospect for a company or a business or a stocks?
The major contributor, if you ask me, the business or the industry they are in.
Ayoyo, this one is hard leh. Ayo, I'm not business savvy.
Padawan, if you really want to be on top of your game when it comes to getting passive income in the form of consistently increasing dividend that support your lifestyle, there's no shortcut to it. You got to learn about businesses not only in Malaysia but around the world and see how it relates to each other. Warren Buffett say it the best, right? Say, actually, I'm a better investor because I'm a businessman, and a better businessman because I'm an investor. Because business and investing is literally joined at the hip. And frankly, that is why a lot of investors fail to achieve a consistently decent return from their investment, because they are too focused on the traditional fundamental or technical analysis, which are all just historical data instead of future prospect of the business and the economy.
I feel this is really overwhelming eh. Can skip this step or not?
Padawan, do you really think investing is like set it up today and forget it? No, because any investment is tied to business. So when business landscape changes for better or for worse, you need to stay ahead and reposition your investment portfolio based on that. Now just look at me, I'm a father already in my 40s. You know, still can get like pimples on my face when you see this? WTF. Other people past their puberty can forget about pimple problem already, but not me. No choice lor, still have to manage one ma. Correct or not?
Isn't that out of topic? But I still love your analogy. I like that. Okay, Lalim, I get where you're coming from. But is there a fast track where you can help me? Bring me up to speed on becoming a better dividend investor. And maybe then review and dissect my existing investment portfolio and give me unbiased advice on how to sustain a consistently growing dividend stocks portfolio year over year.
Sure, check out the description below. There is a link for you to fill in your basic details and we'll take it from there. I am CF Liu, Independence Licensed Advisor. And before you dismiss me as another fake guru making investing videos on YouTube, know that I've been engaged by the biggest bank and the biggest fund house in the country to conduct investment workshops for their staff. So judge me against other YouTubers, financial advisors, unit trust agents, or even fake gurus on the internet. By the way, any dividend paying company or stocks are not obligated to pay regular dividend to you forever as an investor, even if they are increasingly more profitable. Want to know why? Comments below. But this is a big but. There is only one type of public listed company that is always obligated to pay out 90% or more of its profit. Yep, no matter what, whether it's rain or shine, or whether it's pandemic or whatnot. Now, this is the kind of stocks that you always want to have in your portfolio if consistent dividend income is important for you. Check out this other video where I explain it here. And when you love my video so much and sincerely want to support me by joining CF Liu channel insider membership from as low as 10 ringgit per month. Don't forget to also check out these related video lessons on dividend stocks or dividend investing strategies. Now, I hate to see you miss out on these important lessons, right? And don't forget to quick tap on the like button if you have found this useful. I would really appreciate that. And subscribe if you want to get notified of similar videos like this, which you really want, because we have new videos out every single week.